As we discussed in the earlier lecture, primary bronchi divided into secondary bronchi divided into tertiary bronchi divided into terminal bronchioles, terminal bronchioles divided into alveolar ducts, alveolar ducts, terminal bronchioles divided into respiratory bronchioles. This is terminal bronchiole divided into respiratory bronchiole divided into alveolar ducts. Alveolar ducts finally turn up into the alveolar sac. In the similar way, whatever we studied in the last lecture, we will write all the things in the form of flowchart. Primary bronchi secondary bronchi tertiary bronchi divided into terminal bronchioles terminal bronchioles divided into respiratory bronchioles divided into alveolar ducts and alveolar ducts divided into finally turned up into alveolar sac, and alveolar sac consists of very important structural and functional unit of respiratory system, that is alveoli. Structural and functional unit of respiratory system, that is alveoli. The secondary bronchi supplied air to each lobe of the lung. Supply air to each lobe of the lung. Tertiary bronchi, which supply air to bronchopulmonary segment. I already discussed that point. Suppose this is the left lung, it is divided into two lobes. Again, lobes divided into segments. Their small parts are called as segments, and segment divided into lobules. So tertiary bronchi supply air to bronchopulmonary segments. Cartilages are present in primary, secondary and tertiary bronchi. Cartilages present. Cartilages present here also. Cartilages present, which are hyaline cartilage. Only epiglottis is made up of elastic cartilage. Cartilages present. Is present, but bronchioles do not supported by cartilages. So cartilages are absent in bronchioles. Cartilages are absent. Bronchioles and its branches do not contain cartilages. Cartilages absent. Rather, they are the wall of bronchial. The wall of bronchial made up of smooth muscle. Wall of bronchial made up of smooth muscle. Okay, and this smooth muscle help in expansion of the bronchioles. So as air come in the lungs, bronchioles get expand. This will not happen with the bronchi. जैस air inhale होना तेवेस bronchi ची साइज वाढणार नाही. ब्रोंक्युअल ची साइज नक्कीच वाढणार. ब्रोंक्युअल्स कमी जास्त होऊ शकतात एज एअर गेट इनहेल अँड एक्झेल. दिस द वॉल ऑफ ब्रोंक्युअल इज मेड अप ऑफ स्मूथ मसल विच कंटेन्स पल्मोनरी स्ट्रेच रिसेप्टर. इट कंटेन्स contains pulmonary stretch receptor, very important, pulmonary stretch receptor. And this pulmonary stretch receptor defines how much air should be inhaled. Pulmonary stretch receptor, which initiate reflex is called as Herring breather reflex. When we try to inhale too much air, but there is a limit. अपन किती ही एक्सरसाइज केली, किती ही विगरस एक्सरसाइज केली असेल, किंवा ट्रेकिंगला जात असेल, कुठेतरी आपल्याला क्लाइंब करायचं असेल, एक्सरसाइज होत असताना जास्त इनहेलेशन आणि एक्सहेलेशन होत असतं. आपल्याला एक पर्टिक्युलर अमाऊंट ऑफ एअर आपण इनहेल करू शकतो, पण ती अमाऊंट डिफाईन केली जाते. कितीही अमाऊंट आपण इनहेल करू शकत नाही, तर किती अमाऊंट इनहेल केली जाऊ शकते हे ठरवलं जातं या रिफ्लेक्सेस थ्रू. वेन देर इज अ वेन द बियॉन्ड द लिमिट एअर इज इनहेल्ड, पल्मोनरी स्ट्रेच रिसेप्टर इनिशिएट रिफ्लेक्स कॉल्ड एज हेरिंग ब्रीदर रिफ्लेक्स दैट प्रिवेंट लंग फ्रॉम ओवर इन्फ्लेशन. दैट प्रिवेंट दीज रिफ्लेक्सेस prevent lung from over inflation during forceful inhalation. Okay, so the part which is primary bronchi, secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi is known as conducting zone. This is known as conducting zone, also known as the remaining part, terminal bronchial, respiratory bronchial, alveolar ducts, alveolar sac and alveoli. This is called as respiratory zone. Okay, and the branches, when we talk about the branches, primary bronchi will look like a stem, its branches will look like a branches of a tree. Further branching, this tertiary bronchi and its bronchioles, the whole structure is called as a respiratory tree. From the trachea will be the main stem, its branches will look like the branches of a tree, stem, branches of a tree, branches la parat branches, so it is a tree, but it is inverted tree. So the whole structure from the trachea to the alveoli is called as respiratory tree. Okay, the very important thing, this connections of these branchings is called as bronchial intercom. So whatever we study here is nothing but bronchial intercom. And in bronchial intercom we look into the different branches. Okay, so this primary bronchi, secondary bronchi and tertiary bronchi as well as terminal bronchioles come under bronchial tree. This is bronchial tree, which include primary bronchi, secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi and terminal bronchioles. And the from the zone called as respiratory bronchial, alveolar duct, alveolar sac and alveoli is called as respiratory tree.
respiratory tree.
And the whole concept is known as bronchial intercom. Bronchial intercom. Okay. So the part two, this primary bronchi enter into the lung is called as root of lung. Actually, there is no only one thing enter into the lung. Here there are three openings. No either on other sides anything will be entered into the lungs. There is only one side through structures get entered into the lungs. So here the part two bronchi is entering into the lungs. Also there are two more openings through which blood vessels, lymphatic vessels and nerves enter into the lungs. That is known as root of lung. This is known as root of lung. Root of lung is called as hilum. Root of lung is called as hilum, which provides entry to, which is the site of entry for very important blood vessels, lymphatic vessels and nerves. Lymphatic vessel and nerves. Blood vessels of the lungs includes pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein. Pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein. Lymphatic vessels, for protection it contains lymphs, various protective cells, lymphocytes, T lymphocyte and B lymphocyte, and nerves. The nerve which supply to the lung is called as vagus nerve. This is vagus nerve. Vagus nerve, which actually parasympathetic branch of the vagus nerve enter into the nerve, where enter into the lungs. Sympathetic also enter into the lungs. Sympathetic and parasympathetic. So when we talk about the nerve supply, there is a sympathetic as well as parasympathetic nerve supply to the lungs. Sympathetic nerve supply having norepinephrine as the hormone. Sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve innervation. कोणत्या nerve supply करतात lungs साठी? तर दोन टाइपचे nerve supply करतात, sympathetic and parasympathetic. Sympathetic and parasympathetic. Sympathetic nerve hormone is norepinephrine. That is noradrenaline, and parasympathetic hormone is acetylcholine. Okay. So nerve innervation to the lungs conducts many activities like relaxation of smooth muscle and decreased secretion of glands. Relaxation of smooth muscle, norepinephrine due to which smooth muscles of the lungs that is present in bronchioles get relaxed. Relaxation of smooth muscle and decreased secretion of glands. This activity is very important to the asthmatic patient. Please try to understand the things. To any patient of asthma, the thing is that air is inhaled properly but not exhaled. Inspired होऊ शकतो पण air जे आतमध्ये गेली ती expired होऊ शकत नाही, बाहेर येऊ शकत नाही. काय होऊ शकत नाही? कारण ब्रोंकियल ट्री जो आहे ब्रोंकियल ट्री और ब्रोंकियल ट्री साइज गेट डिक्रीज्ड ड्यू टू द सिक्रेशन ऑफ म्यूकस ग्लैंड्स. टू मच अमाउंट म्यूकस इज सिक्रेटेड इनसाइड द प्राइमरी ब्रोंकाई, सेकेंडरी ब्रोंकाई, टर्शियरी ब्रोंकाई. ओके एंड स्मूथ मसल्स ऑफ द ब्रोंकियल्स गेट कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड. देन norepinephrine get secreted by sympathetic nerves, it relaxes bronchial smooth muscle, so air can be easily exhaled out. The secretions of a mucous gland also decrease, due to which there is a widening of the respiratory tree, the that tubes, primary bronchi, secondary bronchi get widened and the air easily comes out. So this process is very important for asthmatic patient. Norepinephrine is the drug or is the hormone helps to the asthmatic patient to get rid of the situations. Relaxation of smooth muscle and decrease secretion of glands due to the norepinephrine. Acetylcholine shows activity opposite to the norepinephrine. It causes constriction of a smooth muscle. It causes constriction of smooth muscle and also increases glandular secretions and it worsens the situations of asthma. आणखी क्रिटिकल सिच्युएशन मध्ये टाकणार. एसिटाइलकोलीन जर सिक्रीट होत असेल अस्थमॅटिक पेशंट मध्ये तर सिच्युएशन आणखी वर्स्ट होणार आहे. अस्थमॅटिक पेशंट विल गोइंग टू द स्टेज कॉल्ड एज स्टॅटस अस्थमॅटिकस, म्हणजे कंटिन्यू अटॅक राहत असतो. 10-5 मिनिटांनी जो रिलीफ मिळणार आहे अस्थमॅटिक पेशंटला तो तसा होत नाही. अर्धा तास पाऊन तास अस्थमाचा अटॅक राहतो आणि पेशंटच्या याच्यामध्ये डेथ होऊ शकते. ओके, दिस इज अ नर्व इनोव्हेशन. As I talk about, hilum is the part called as the root of the nerve through which blood vessel, lymphatic vessel and nerves are entered into it. So blood vessels or the circulation to the lungs consist of two types. Circulation to the lung consist of two types. One is called bronchial circulation, other one is called pulmonary circulation. Bronchial circulation and pulmonary circulation. Pulmonary circulation includes circulation to the lung is of two types. One is pulmonary circulation. Bronchial circulation. Bronchial circulation. Pulmonary circulation is used when from the heart pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood to the lungs. Pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood to the lungs. In the lungs, that deoxygenated blood get converted into oxygenated blood, and oxygenated blood again transported to the heart. So the circulation of blood between heart to lungs and again lungs to heart is called as pulmonary circulation. So it carry deoxygenated blood from body parts to lungs. Heart is the pumping organ just. So deoxygenated blood from body to lungs is nothing but pulmonary circulation. Deoxygenated blood from body to lungs by means of the intermediate organs like heart and pulmonary artery is called as pulmonary circulation, and it returns to the body oxygenated blood.
ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड
वाया इसके थ्रू जाता है, दैट इज पल्मोनरी वेन, पल्मोनरी वेन. ओके एंड ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड किसके थ्रू आता है, दैट इज पल्मोनरी आर्टरी, पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. व्हेन वी स्टडी इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ हार्ट एंड द कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू द हार्ट, यू विल गेट पल्मोनरी आर्टरी एंड पल्मोनरी वेन वेयर इट इज प्रेजेंट एंड हाउ इट ट्रांसपोर्ट ब्लड टू द लंग्स फ्रॉम द हार्ट एंड फ्रॉम लंग्स टू द हार्ट. ओके जे दोघांमध्ये सर्क्युलेशन आहे, हार्टकडून लंग्स कडे, लंग्स कडून हार्टकडे जे ब्लड असतं ना जाताना ते डिऑक्सिजनेटेड असतं, लंग्स कडे जातच ऑक्सिजनेशनसाठी आणि लंग्स कडून परत हार्टकडे येतं, हार्टकडून पुन्हा बॉडीकडे जातं. तर मध्ये ज्या ब्लड वेसल्स आहेत सगळ्यात त्यांना म्हणायचं पल्मोनरी सर्क्युलेशन, त्यांच्या थ्रू जे होणार सर्क्युलेशन दॅट इज पल्मोनरी सर्क्युलेशन अँड ब्रॉन्कियल सर्क्युलेशन. ब्रॉन्कियल सर्क्युलेशन it includes supply of oxygenated blood to tissue of lungs from the systemic aorta, one branch will arise called as bronchial artery through which blood is supplied to the tissue of lungs. This is all about the circulation of lungs. Muscles of respiration will be the next point. So nerves of innervation, circulation and muscles of respiration. There will be only two muscles of respiration. One is called as diaphragm, very important, diaphragm on which lungs are situated, and intercostal muscles which is present between the ribs ke beech mein jo muscles present rehte unhe kehte hain intercostal muscles, and lungs jis pe situated rehte unhe use kehte hain diaphragm. Okay, these both are muscles of respiration. Okay, so in the next lecture we will talk about details of alveoli, which is structural and functional unit of respiration.